Hello, and welcome to this video. This is a summary of the book, Hands-on Data Preprocessing in Python. Subtitle, Learn How to Effectively Prepare Data for Successful Analytics. This is the author, Roy Jafari. The book has four parts, and in this video, we will go over them quickly. Let's start with part one, technical requirements. This part covers four chapters. In the first two chapters, we will learn about three core Python modules, NumPy, Pandas, and Matplotlib. To be able to use these chapters, one needs to be comfortable with basic programming concepts such as defining variables, loops, and conditionals. In chapter three, we will go into depth about what is data and examine the pathways from data to data visualization, and also from data to actions in machine learning. This chapter will serve as a conceptual foundation of data preprocessing. In chapter 4, we will talk about the technological foundations of data analytics and machine learning, that is, databases. We will learn about the important role databases play in our journey from data collection to insight. Now, let's move to the second part of the book, analytic goals. Some readers may be familiar with the content in this part of the book and may skip it. As you can see, this part includes four chapters: data visualization, prediction, classification, and clustering analysis. It may sound counterintuitive to learn about these before learning about data preprocessing. After all, analytics comes after data preprocessing. But here's the catch. We preprocess the data for the analytics, and for effective data preprocessing, we need to understand how the data will be used. This is what distinguishes this book from the rest of the data cleaning books in the market. Data cleaning is often presented as a process that can be done in isolation, regardless of the analytics. And that is far from the truth. Effective data cleaning and pre-processing are done while informed about the analytics they want to support. Now let's move to the third part of the book, the pre-processing. This is the meat of the book, and everything the book covers up until this point only prepares the reader for effective learning of this part of the book. The preprocessing part has six chapters. You can see these chapters here. Let us go over them quickly. The book divides the data cleaning process into three levels, as presented in chapters 9, 10, and 11. The first level, cleaning up the table, is the only data cleaning that can be done in isolation of the analytic tools and goals. The second level covers techniques and understanding that one would need to be able to unpack, restructure, or reformulate the dataset for supporting analytics. Lastly, level 3 is all about the correctness and existence of the records in the data. Essentially, chapter 11 discusses how best to detect and deal with missing values, outliers, and errors. Each of the other three chapters in this part of the book covers one of the important steps of data preprocessing. Let us first talk about chapter 12, data fusion and data integration. This step is about mixing data sources. As simple as that. However, this simplicity does not carry itself to implementation. Combining data sources is challenging, and chapter 12 of the book introduces six challenges of data integration, and uses examples to show how best they can be dealt with. The next chapter, chapter 13, data reduction, covers many categories of data reduction such as numerosity data reduction and dimensionality data reduction. Under dimension reduction, the chapter covers four supervised methods and two very powerful unsupervised methods. This chapter, besides helping the readers to understand the assortment of methods for data reduction, it also enables them to appreciate the whys behind the data reduction and also empowers them to select the best method for each analytic situation. Lastly, chapter 14 covers various data transformation and massaging methods such as feature extraction, smoothing, aggregation, binning, log transformation, and discretization. These methods enable the readers to take their analytics effectiveness to the next level by optimizing the data readiness for analytics. Finally, we arrive at the fourth part of the book, case studies. Let me use a quick analogy to explain this part. We all know during a soccer game, professional soccer players need to be able to use their skills such as dribbling, passing, defending, and shooting at the same time, in tandem, or at times even combined. Similarly, in a real analytic project, you may need to perform the data preprocessing steps covered in this book at the same time, combined, or in tandem. Chapters 15 to 17 are real case studies that give the readers a taste of how all data preprocessing steps come together. Finally, chapter 18 offers directions and practices for more learning. While at the end of each chapter, from chapters 1 to 14, readers can find meaningful exercises to solidify their learning, there will be nothing like having the experience of going through the data preprocessing journey on your own and making decisions, and perhaps here and there make mistakes. That is when you learn. As we come to the end of this summary video, let me encourage you to check out more learning resources related to the book and other learning materials on my website at roy-jafari.com or on my YouTube channel. I enjoyed writing this book. I hope you will enjoy reading it and learning from it. Happy learning, everyone.